Welcome to the Ask Brad Show. Be prepared to hear ideas, concepts, and strategies that may challenge the way you were taught to think about saving and investing for retirement. It's time to roll up our sleeves and get to it. And now, the host of the Ask Brad Show, here's Brad Williams.
Well, welcome back. Appreciate you listening to the Ask Brad Show. And in my effort to provide timely and important information, I've got a special guest today. And I know I spend most of the time talking about markets and ups and downs and investment strategies. But, you know, it's also about life strategies. It's also about you can't control what happens to you, but you can control what you do about it. And so divorce is a big issue in our society today. Can't turn away from it. It's not a desired thing, but it happens. And so being informed and knowing what to do in advance really has a huge bearing on your finances. I've watched a good friend of mine go through a divorce, and they ended up spending over $50,000 on an attorney because they couldn't agree on anything. And that really just broke my heart to watch that. So today, my special guest is Kelly Cummings Smith. And I met her recently at one of my networking meetings, and she had a novel approach. Her company's New Life Divorce Solutions. And welcome, Kelly.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Kelly, tell us what you are, because I see that here, but why don't you explain to our audience what you are?
Well, I am a CPA, but I also have a designation as a certified divorce financial analyst. And a certified divorce financial analyst is someone who has a financial background, and they are specially trained in the financial issues related to divorce.
All right. And is it tough to get that kind of certification?
Well, you have to meet minimum education requirements. You have to have a background in finance. You have to pass an exam similar to a CPA exam. And then you have to maintain continuing education credits. And they have ethical standards that you must abide by.
Okay. Well, that sounds good enough. Now, who would come to you?
Well, I can work with people going through a divorce, either couples who have mutually decided that they want to end their marriage, but they don't want to get into a contentious court battle. I can work with individuals, someone who I like to say is surprised by divorce. Their spouse comes home and says, okay, I'm done. And suddenly they don't know what to do and they don't understand the finances in their household. I can also work with attorneys. I can do expert witness testimony regarding the value of assets. I can do what's called asset tracing, which is trying to find things that people think that their spouse may have hidden.
Yeah, may have squirreled it away somewhere.
Yeah. And then I can also work with mediators. Mediation is becoming popular as another way to avoid court. But your mediator usually would benefit from understanding the financial situation of your marriage before they make recommendations on how to settle your case.
All right. And so once someone comes to you, I'm assuming you have a process you go through of discovering what's going on and where things are and all that?
Absolutely. I have a list of things that I request from the couple or from the individual, things like your tax returns, your bank statements, your credit card statements, and I do an analysis of your financial position, where you are now. I can help determine what is marital property versus separate property, and then look at the best possible options for a settlement.
Okay. Now, if somebody's already engaged an attorney, would you be somebody to come in and help out the situation?
Absolutely. I like to say that attorneys know the law. They've been trained in the law, but most of them are not trained in finances.
Okay.
So they don't fully understand all the nuances within the financial world. Right. You know, as a financial person yourself, you know, there is a significant difference between a Roth IRA and a traditional IRA.
On withdrawal, especially.
Yeah, exactly. And even, you know, in estate planning. But if your attorney doesn't fully understand that, then they may look at those, if they have the same value, as being of equal value to divide. And that's not necessarily the case. And so having someone that can help you understand what your future will look like and understand that what looks like it's 50-50 on paper may or may not actually be 50-50. When you consider tax ramifications, when you consider the future ability to withdraw the money and that type of thing, it's important to understand those differences, and your attorney may or may not be able to explain those to you.
And that makes sense because, like you mentioned, a Roth IRA and a traditional IRA. So if you've got $200,000 in each And so, well, you take the Roth and I'll take the individual. Well, that's not even, because the Roth is going to be tax-free on distribution.
Right. And it can be transferred to your heirs, tax-free to them.
Exactly.
Where your 401k is not.
Right. Okay. Well, that's good. That's good. So do you find that couples come to you when they find out about you as they're going through this? How does that usually work?
I have worked with a lot of couples that are in that situation. You know, not everybody that's going through a divorce is angry with each other. Right. You know, sometimes it's just we've grown apart. We don't want to drag our family through a mess. We don't want this to drag on for a long time. How do we resolve this, remain friends, and move on with our lives? So even after they've spoken to attorneys, they still have come to me, and we've worked on the settlement. I call myself a settlement facilitator because I work just with the financial aspect. If you have child custody issues and other issues related to divorce, that would need to be dealt with by your attorney.
Okay. All right. Well, these are some good points, and we'll be back in just a minute to continue our discussion with Kelly Cummings Smith, New Life Divorce Solutions.
If you own a 401k, an IRA, 403b, or any other retirement account, and you're between the ages of 64 and 72, this message is for you. Consider this your personal invitation to join Brad Williams for a special educational event at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. Brad's going to be talking about how to calculate your RMDs, does a Roth conversion make sense for you, tax-saving strategies, and setting up beneficiaries to help create maximum tax efficiency. This educational event will be held Thursday, June 13th, 2 p.m., and Tuesday, June 18th, 2 p.m., at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. To reserve your seat, call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. This is not a sales seminar, and the workshop is free and no obligation. Reserve your seat today at 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
All right, we're back now. And again, my special guest today on the Ask Brad Show is Kelly Cummings Smith. She's a CPA and a CDFA. I'll have to admit, that's a new one to me, which is Certified Divorce Financial Analyst, correct?
That's correct.
And we were talking about splitting things up in a divorce situation from a financial standpoint. And that's, again, that's where your focus is in the financial aspects of it, right?
That's correct. Yeah, I'm not an attorney. And so I don't offer legal advice. But one thing that I think people don't fully understand is the law has guidelines when it comes to division of things. And then a judge has authority to make decisions. But if you can come to those decisions yourself and they're not really out of alignment with equitable division, then they will be approved. You don't have to go through the guideline process if both parties agree.
Okay.
And you don't necessarily want the state to make those decisions for you, or a judge who doesn't fully understand your life and your lifestyle, your finances, to make those decisions for you if you have the opportunity to make them for yourself.
Well, and I know, for example, when I'm working with couples in their retirement planning, oftentimes you have one spouse that's heavily involved in the finances and the other that really isn't. And I'm always coaching them to make sure that they understand things so that when the one who's involved is not there anymore, they're good to go. And at least they have some understanding of what's going on, because that can be a real eye opener. And I would imagine a divorce situation when you got maybe a housewife who was raising the children and the man leaves, and now she's having to figure out how to pay the bills and all that on her own.
Absolutely. You know, I find that most marriages have what I call the family CFO.
Right.
The person who is responsible for paying the bills, and they know what money's coming in. They know what investments they have. They know the insurance policies. And then the other spouse, often not because they're disinterested, but because they're busy and they trust their spouse that they're taking care of it. You know, they have money to buy the groceries or do their hobby or whatever. And so they just rock along, everything being fine. What happens when the person who's the CFO decides that they don't want to be married anymore, then the person that's not the CFO suddenly is unaware and finds themselves at a disadvantage.
Right.
The other side of that is, even if you are the CFO and you're going through a divorce and maybe it's somewhat contentious, the emotional side of divorce can cause you to have what I call brain fog.
Right.
And there are, you know, there are psychological studies that talk about that. And sometimes it's just overwhelming with all of the things associated with divorce, and you need a voice of reason to keep you calm and walk you through the process and be able to pull the information that you provide together to offer settlement options, because you're so emotionally invested that it's sometimes hard to be objective.
Well, and I would imagine one other issue you got to deal with is expectations, because here you have successful life together in a nice house and good income and plenty of cash flow. Things change when that one household support goes to two.
Absolutely. And, you know, the reality is a lot of people have debt. And sometimes the CFO spouse knows about the debt and the non-CFO spouse isn't aware.
Okay.
And, you know, there are things you can do in a divorce situation, depending on what assets are there, to minimize the tax impacts and be able to give each party a clean slate to start debt-free.
Okay.
And,
that's a good idea.
A lot of people don't understand that. But if you can start your life out not in debt, your new separate life, what I call your new life,
right,
without debt and with a solid plan for your financial future, that is empowering to you and gives you confidence to move forward.
Those are real good points. And so part of your process is, of course, the discovery, right, where you go through and these are the assets, these are the debts. So that's when the one who may have been in the dark gets their eyes open about what they're really dealing with, right?
Right, right. And you know, they may think that they have a bunch of money. Well, we make good money, so surely there's a stash somewhere. And sometimes there is, and sometimes there isn't. And we can determine that. But if there isn't, then you need to understand what the real financial situation is so you don't have unrealistic expectations of what the settlement would be.
Okay. Well, we're going to take another break here and then come into our last segment with Kelly Cummings Smith of New Life Divorce Solutions.
At Brad Williams Financial Services, our goal is to develop enduring, long-term personal relationships with our clients, knowing that you have placed your trust in our expertise and dedication. To learn more about Brad Williams Financial Services or to set up a complimentary review,
call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
If you own a 401k, an IRA, 403b, or any other retirement account, and you're between the ages of 64 and 72, this message is for you. Consider this your personal invitation to join Brad Williams for a special educational event at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. Brad's going to be talking about how to calculate your RMDs, does a Roth conversion make sense for you, tax-saving strategies, and setting up beneficiaries to help create maximum tax efficiency. This educational event will be held Thursday, June 13th, 2 p.m., and Tuesday, June 18th, 2 p.m., at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. To reserve your seat, call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. This is not a sales seminar, and the workshop is free and no obligation. Reserve your seat today at 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
All right, now we're back, and again, we're with Kelly Cummings Smith today. She's our special guest, and she's with New Life Divorce Solutions, and she deals with the financial aspects of divorce. Not a pleasant topic, but it's nonetheless one we have to deal with. It's kind of like estate planning. Nobody wants to think about that phase in their life, but it's coming. Now, not necessarily for divorce, but divorce happens. So, Kelly, tell my audience, how'd you manage to get into doing what you're doing?
Well, I was a paralegal before I went and finished my degree and became a CPA, and I went through a divorce myself. My husband was talking to a woman at our church that he'd known for a long time, and she was going through a divorce. One of those situations where her husband was the CFO, raised the family. He comes in and tells her that now that their last child has gone to college, he is ready to move on with his life. And he offered her a settlement that basically said, we'll split the equity in the house, I'll keep my retirement, and I'll give you $500 a month. And so on top of the emotional rejection and all the turmoil that comes with that, she's thinking, I can't live on $500 a month.
Right.
I'm going to end up living under a bridge. So when I spoke with her and I walked her through that process, the legal process can be a little intimidating if you've never dealt with it. And a lot of people haven't. They use big words like interrogatories and discovery and, you know, complaints and motions and all of those things that, if you're not familiar with it, can be very intimidating and you're already emotional. Walked her through that process, helped her pull all the information together to provide to her attorney. And at the end of the process, she was a different person. She had self-confidence. She felt like she had control over her situation. Her attorney complimented her. She said, I don't know who helped you with this, but they saved you a lot of time and a lot of money by providing it to me in the way that it was provided. And I felt like I had made a difference in her life.
Well, information's power, isn't it?
It is. And so after that experience, I decided I have a heart to help people and that this would be a good way to help people going through a very difficult situation to feel empowered and regain control of the direction of their life. And so I researched what certifications were out there and found the Certified Divorce Financial Analyst. And I took that certification course and I've been a CDFA for 11 years.
Wow. And you know, it's all about knowing what's in front of you. And I would imagine with what you do, you can take a lot of the uncertainties out of the process. Now, if you've got children, there's a lot of uncertainty. How is this going to come in the long run? All the emotional and familial things. But when it comes to the finances, to be able to nail that down like you do for folks, I would imagine takes a lot of burden off of them.
It does. And it gives people some security. I have a program that once I put all the information in, we can project within, you know, parameters. Obviously, in the financial world, if I could tell you what the future was going to hold, I would be in a different position. But within certain parameters, how they're going to fare in the future.
Okay.
And, you know, when you see that you're going to be able to still have a retirement, that your children are still going to be able to go to college, that, you know, you're going to be able to live a comfortable life and not end up under a bridge, as my friend thought that she would.
Sure.
You know, that's a tremendous relief.
That's awesome. So as we're closing up on this segment, just to give my audience a better idea, I know they probably intuitively understand what you do. Why don't you give us an idea of some of the services you provide so they might understand whether these apply to them if they're going through that?
Well, as we discussed, a settlement facilitator, which means I help people who are in the process of divorce determine the best financial settlement for both parties. If you're already in a divorce and you're evaluating settlement offers, I can help you look at those and analyze those to see whether they're equitable and if they're going to provide for your needs. If you need an expert witness to discuss a pension valuation or other financial issues, I can do that if you're already within the court case.
All right.
And I can help you understand your financial situation if you are the non-CFO spouse and you're unsure of how to handle things. And then be a financial coach, so to speak, to help you come up with your budget and learn how to manage your money so that you know going forward that you're going to be able to be successful.
And so how would they get in touch with you?
Well, you can contact me at newlifedivorcesolutions.com. And my phone number is 256-694-8594.
Great. Now, we really appreciate you coming. As I try to do periodically is bring someone who's not dealing with the markets like I do. My intent for this show is to educate North Alabama and specifically Huntsville in many different financial topics. And this is one of them.
This is one of them.
So again, this was Kelly Cummings Smith from New Life Divorce Solutions. If you caught her number, great. You can always get with us at 844-343-6048 if you didn't get her number on the way. And, of course, our usual call-in number, or just check with AskBradShow.com. That's AskBradShow.com. Again, Kelly, thank you for coming.
Thank you so much. I've enjoyed it.
I've enjoyed it as well.
At Brad Williams Financial Services, we believe in innovative thinking, and we're not afraid to challenge conventional methods in our approach to managing, investing, and preserving wealth. To learn more about Brad Williams Financial Services or to set up a complimentary review,
call 844-844-844. 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
Have you missed any of today's show? Would you like to listen to past shows? We've got you covered 24/7. Visit AskBradShow.com. That's AskBradShow.com. Now, another lightning round. Lightning round. Lightning round. Lightning.
All right, listeners, I'm going to add a new segment to our show called the Lightning Round. And in that, each week I'm going to address some pertinent issue that I think is important for retirees to know about. And this week we're going to discuss the Secure Bill. And that is setting every community up for Retirement Enhancement Act of 2019. Boy, Congress sure loves to put the words in those bills. But what has happened is a bipartisan bill to change a lot of the provisions for retirement accounts. It's gone through the House pretty easily. It's in the Senate now. We'll see what could come of it. One challenge could be money, because there's some good things, there's some bad things in it. And we're going to go through each of those, as I think would apply to my listeners out there. The basics. Well, creates a safe harbor that employers could use when choosing group annuities. So they're going to add an annuity provision in there for lifetime income for those who want to participate. You could transfer that from one plan to another. And this is one of the big ones. Even over 70 and a half, you'll still be able to contribute to an IRA if you're still working. That's real good provision. Provides tax credit for small employers that start a new retirement plan with an auto enrollment feature. And it allows small employers to participate in multiple employer plans. So those are good things. And, you know, there are a lot of people that like it. Of course, life insurers like it because of the annuity provision. And one of the big things is it changes the required minimum distribution from 70 and a half to 72. That doesn't sound like much, but it can be. I know a lot of my clients, when they're getting ready for those RMDs, they really don't need to take them. They just have to. And so that becomes an issue. So, you know, that's a good thing that they're going to bump that RMD age up. As we're living longer, it helps make sure that we don't drain our retirement accounts too quick. When I first read that of the bill, that it raises it from 70 and a half to 72, I was like, well, that is great. Congress is actually doing something positive. And then I realized there's got to be something in that, and it is. And that is the stretch IRA provision. As I have said many times, Congress is like a broke clock. It's only right twice a day. But it is good that they're bumping the RMDs up to 72 instead of 70 and a half if it passes. The downside to that is that the stretch IRA provision that allows someone to pass their IRA to someone else and continue the tax deferral on it as long as they live. So, you know, you leave that to your 45-year-old child, for example, when you die, and they don't need it yet. They're still working. They're in their high income years. They can just take a small required minimum distribution based on their life expectancy currently, and then maybe take larger chunks of it when they retire. Well, this bill would require that account to be drained in 10 years. That's big. That's real big, because so many of my clients have used the stretch IRA provision, and it's going to change that. Now, we're looking to see if there's some estate planning things that can be done through trusts and all that to help mitigate that, but we're not sure yet. Back nearly 20 years ago, when you inherited an IRA, you either had to take it that year, take it out over a five-year period, or at the end of 5 years, had to have it drained. And then they added the stretch provision, which allowed you to take it out over your life expectancy. So you could actually leave it to a grandchild, and they take a very minimum amount out. Let's say they're 10 years old, and it stretches out over their life. It was a great planning tool to pass your wealth down in an efficient manner and continue the tax deferral. Well, that provision in it looks like it's gone, and it'll be a 10-year payout. Now, that's going to really have a negative impact on a lot of folks who inherit IRAs who are still working and have a few years left to work. So we'll see how that comes out. But that's one of the downsides of it. As everything, there's a downside. There's a few other provisions in it. It allows child and adoption credits and penalty-free withdrawals for family leave, education savings provisions to allow college savings or 529 plans to use those for K-12 expenses. And that's good. That gives you more choice in your schooling. These are good things that are going to come about as a result of this bill, but I think the really negative part is the 10-year payout in an IRA. So a lot of trusts have been set up with certain provisions to take advantage of that stretch IRA, and they're going to have to be redone now. Just keep that in mind. And again, this is the SECURE bill, Setting Every Community Up for Retirement Enhancement Act of 2019. And just in a nutshell, it does raise the required minimum distribution age from 70 and a half to 72. That's good. Allow some college savings to be used for K through 12. That's good. Make some employer plans more eligible. Gives them provisions to give more small employers an opportunity to do that. But it does get rid of the stretch provision. That's big. So that's our lightning round today. Got any questions? Give us a call. 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
If you own a 401k, an IRA, 403b, or any other retirement account, and you're between the ages of 64 and 72, this message is for you. Consider this your personal invitation to join Brad Williams for a special educational event at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. Brad's going to be talking about how to calculate your RMDs, does a Roth conversion make sense for you, tax-saving strategies, and setting up beneficiaries to help create maximum tax efficiency. This educational event will be held Thursday, June 13th, 2 p.m., and Tuesday, June 18th, 2 p.m., at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. To reserve your seat, call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. This is not a sales seminar, and the workshop is free and no obligation. Reserve your seat today at 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
You remember that old game you used to play at kids' parties? You know, the one where they play the record, and then all of a sudden, whoop, the record stops, and you got to scrounge for a chair, and they always make to where there's one less chair than everybody there, and then one person has to get out of the game and go sit down, and then everybody else starts circling the remaining chairs. And so everybody's wanting to make sure that when the music stops, they're not left without a chair. Are you kind of feeling that way about your retirement with the market? Well, if you're within 5 years of retirement, you need to listen to this show, because we're going to address specific things to make sure you're not left standing without a chair when the music stops. And you know, so many of those games as kids were so much fun, but you know, you were stressed out. You didn't want to be the one left standing, but you know, ultimately there's only going to be one person left and they were going to be the winner. Well, you know, retirement doesn't have to be that way. There doesn't have to be only one winner. But the sad fact of the matter is, when you look at statistics, that only about 5 people out of 100 are truly financially independent when they retire. You know, when you think about the great opportunities in this country and people work so hard, we're probably the hardest working people in the world. And I wouldn't doubt that a bit. We put in longer hours than the rest of the world. You know, they have riots over in France for more vacation. So we've got to look at things for our retirement differently now. You know, we're coming out of a long bull market and the market cycles. And anybody who's come in to see me, you know, I speak a lot on market history and trends and cycles. And I think that's important to look at, because when you retire in a cycle is really going to drive some of the things you do. But today, I want to talk about 10 steps you need to take before you retire, and especially if you're within 5 years of retiring. Because if you look at retirement like climbing a mountain, you know, that climb up the mountain, that's your accumulation phase. And I like to use this analogy because I think it's quite descriptive. So you're working, you're putting money away, you know, you're doing all the right things, putting in your 401k, building up your Social Security, all these things. And you get to the peak of the mountain, and that peak of the mountain, that's your retirement. You've gotten to that pinnacle where you've had a lifetime of hard work. You've raised your kids, hopefully paid off your house, done some great things, maybe sent the kids to college. Now they've got their families and they're doing good and you're proud of them. And you're right at that pinnacle now and retirement starts. Well, you've now gone from the accumulation phase to the distribution phase of retirement. And you know what, folks? All the rules changed. As much as you hate to think about that, the rules have changed. Your income is going to be dependent on what you do with what you've accumulated to this point in your life. Yes, you got Social Security, and maybe you're lucky enough to have a pension. But making sure you take care of what you've accumulated in that nest egg is very, very important. And I often cite the fact that there's a stage in the middle there that's often overlooked. You know, we got the accumulation stage and the distribution phase, climbing up the mountain, going down the mountain. But there's a preservation phase during that transition that a lot of people forget about. That's when you start de-risking your portfolio. That's when you start changing your focus from growth to income. And in fact, that's what my practice focuses on, is income-oriented investments and looking at how do you create the streams of income that give you the flexibility to do the things you want to do in life. And so we're going to talk about those things today, and we're going to cover a lot of things that I think you'll find interesting and hopefully informative that will help you in that transition period, that preservation period where you're making the decisions into retirement to make that retirement much more stress-free and happy. As we look at 10 steps to take before you retire, I think the number one is, what does retirement mean to you? I mean, what do you truly want to do in retirement? You don't want to just go away. You want to be productive. Now, a lot of people, I've got clients that continue to do consulting. They may work part-time at their job. There's a lot of highly skilled people in this town, and got a lot of them as my clients who are in high demand, and they can control their hours. And that's good if you start positioning yourself in that way. Now, some people aren't that way. It's, you know, they're either working or they're not. You might find a part-time job. You might find a way to begin turning your hobby into something that will, you know, that will generate income for you. So that number one thing is, what do you want your retirement to be? Is it about spending time with your family? Is it about spending time with your spouse, maybe traveling? And one caution I would say, I've got one client that really worked hard to make sure that they had plenty in retirement, that him and his wife had plenty in retirement. And then right as he finally got to it, he put it off several times, his wife got sick and they never got to enjoy it. So when you're preparing for retirement, don't overdo it. You know, look at what you need, but don't think you got to overpad it and end up missing some of the things you've worked for so hard in your life. Because I think that's something he really regrets, is that, you know, he wanted to be so secure that he gave up something he'll never get back. So I think the second thing, make sure you have an emergency fund, because you don't know what's going to happen. And that emergency fund can encompass many things. What I'm finding more and more is that a lot of my clients are taking care of grandkids or maybe their kids in one way or another. And maybe their kids haven't done a good job and they're handling their grandkids, or, you know, something happened in their lives where they're not there. So, you know, having the money to do that as well as doing what you want to do in retirement is important. But I think it all goes back to the first one, which, you know, determine what retirement means to you, what family needs you're going to have, what financial needs those are going to put on you. The third thing would be, if you're thinking about staying in your house and you still have a mortgage and you're wondering, hey, maybe now might be a good time to refinance if you haven't already done so, or maybe you want to change the financing that you're doing, you do it before you quit working. Just make sure that, you know, if you're going to do that, you want to do that now. And number four, and I think this is probably the most important, is you want a detailed financial plan. And that should encompass Social Security. When should you take it? When should your spouse take it? What are the ramifications of those decisions? How you should take your pension if you have a pension? Do you need a survivor benefit? Does that make sense to get that? Where's your income going to come from? Are you going to be taking income from your portfolio? Have you readjusted your portfolio to be providing income to you and not just growth? Because when we get back, I'm going to talk about the difference between a growth advisor and an income advisor. So stay tuned, folks. This is Brad Williams, and I have been privileged to have been an instructor over the last 12 years or so at the Osher Lifelong Learning Institute at the University of Alabama in Huntsville. They have some great course offerings. I'm currently teaching a course that I've written and taught for many years, Changing Face of Retirement in the 21st Century. But that's not all of the courses there. You can learn languages. You can learn hobbies, travel. There are so many things that you can get out of these courses they offer at the Osher Lifelong Learning Institute. So check it out today and come keep your brain working.
For more information on the Osher Lifelong Learning Institute, call 256-824-6183. That's 256-824-6183. Or email olli.info@uah.edu. The Osher Lifelong Learning Institute. Come keep your brain working.
If you own a 401k, an IRA, 403b, or any other retirement account, and you're between the ages of 64 and 72, this message is for you. Consider this your personal invitation to join Brad Williams for a special educational event at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. Brad's going to be talking about how to calculate your RMDs, does a Roth conversion make sense for you, tax-saving strategies, and setting up beneficiaries to help create maximum tax efficiency. This educational event will be held Thursday, June 13th, 2 p.m., and Tuesday, June 18th, 2 p.m., at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. To reserve your seat, call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. This is not a sales seminar, and the workshop is free and no obligation. Reserve your seat today at 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
All right, welcome back. And, you know, right before the break, what I talked about was having a full financial plan and looking at Social Security, looking at your pensions, looking at where you're going to be getting your income, but also addressing your portfolio, because you've got to be able to know what your portfolio is going to do for you. You know, many advisors today are really just financial salespeople. You come in the office, you do a profile, takes you, you know, 10 minutes to do the profile, and it says either you're, you know, conservative, moderate, or aggressive. And then they have a cookie cutter set of funds for each one, wherever you fall in, and you transfer the money in. The next day, it's all invested in whatever those funds are. I would say you probably got a financial salesperson. And as I mentioned mountain climbing in the beginning, you know, when people climb Everest, for example, and let me give you a detail about Everest. The majority of all deaths on mountains like Everest don't happen on the ascent. They happen on the descent. It's not going up the mountain. In our discussion today, that's the accumulation phase. It's the coming down the mountain, the distribution phase. That's when people make mistakes. You know, their resources have been exhausted. They're tired. Maybe they're injured. You know, kind of like a retirement could be. And they start making mistakes, and it oftentimes cost them their lives. So a lot of people, in fact, I think on Mount Everest, you have to have a Sherpa to go up with you. They hire a Sherpa who is that guide that knows the ins and outs of the mountain. And he guides them up and he guides them down. And that's the key. He guides them up and he guides them down. Unfortunately, in our industry, you typically specialize in one or the other. You're either a growth-oriented advisor, you know, you have clients that are, you know, 30, 40, 50, 60, maybe even older, and your main goal is growing their money. And when people start talking about, you know, should I get more conservative? Well, they say, yeah, we'll get in more conservative stocks. And they're still in the market. And there's a universe of income-oriented investments that a lot of people don't look at that are largely unavailable in mutual funds. And those are worth looking at. And so that Sherpa should be able to take you there and have those in the portfolio. But again, so many advisors are financial salespeople, and they're not Sherpas, and their expertise is not making sure that you don't run out of money. And when I say that, I'm not talking about putting your money in a variable annuity that has an income rider, and in the event that all your money's gone, you still have income. That's not what I'm talking about. Variable annuities can be very expensive, and although those income riders sound pretty good, it's kind of like a variable annuity is a tool that can be valuable in the right hands and for the right reasons. But when you're a retiree, it may not be the best choice. And of course, that's something to be determined by your particular situation. So I'm not going to make a blanket statement on that. But think about this. So variable annuity gives you access to the market through the subaccounts, and you have growth in there. Well, you also have what could be a lot of high fees. But what often happens with a financial salesperson is when you come in and they're used to using these variable annuities, they say, you know, I'm concerned about the downside. Oh, okay. Well, we can just throw this income rider on. That way, if for some reason the market goes down, you'll at least be guaranteed this certain amount of income when you retire. So you'll have some safety there. Okay. Well, it might work for some, but you know, when you really look at the details, a lot of people find that may not be for them. It's kind of like going to a Porsche dealership. When you're looking for a family vehicle, you know, a crossover or minivan or something like that, and you go in the Porsche dealership and you say, hey, I need a vehicle. He says, hey, we got this great sports car. Well, you know, I'm going to be driving a lot in the snow. Oh, okay. Well, for an extra charge, we can put these snow tires in the trunk and they'll be ready for you. Okay. Well, you know, that might work. He said, but I may be going over some rough ground and all, and I'm afraid it might roll over. Oh, okay. Well, for this extra fee, we can throw a roll bar on there. And then if you roll over, you're going to be all right. Okay. Well, so what have you got? You've taken a sports car and you've added on these things that really didn't belong, and they're supposed to make you feel safe, when in reality, maybe another vehicle might be the best thing. If you're worried about losing your money, there may be other ways, because a variable annuity is going to be just like the market. It's going to have ups and downs. So when you're looking at income tools, what I'm talking about is not really a variable annuity with an income rider. I'm talking about other things. These are a universe of income-oriented investments that I help my clients with. Now, if you're not sure whether your portfolio is set up for income in retirement and that you're in that preservation phase, that 5-year period before retirement, you need to give me a call, 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. And we can talk about your thoughts and even provide you a free 1-hour consultation to do a brief analysis and show you, are you on track or not? That's 844-343-6048. So getting back to a detailed retirement plan, I think that's important. And that's one of the things that I work with my clients on, is creating a kind of a financial GPS, I like to call it. Because when you look at traveling, and I've used this analogy on my show before, when you're flying, most of the time that plane's off course, and you pilots out there know what I'm talking about. And that GPS figures out, you know, the turbulence, the tailwinds, the cross currents, you know, the weather changes, and it makes sure that when you drift off course, it pulls that nose right back on course. So it's making the small course corrections when they're needed instead of waiting until they get to be big ones. And oftentimes when people come in to see me the first time, maybe they had an advisor they haven't seen in 2 or 3, 5 years, put them in some investments that they're not even sure how they're doing, not even sure whether they're appropriate for them. Maybe they get a Christmas card every now and then, but to sit down and do several reviews a year and make sure they're on course and make the subtle course correction, that may not be the kind of service they're getting. And if that's the case, then that might indicate that you're dealing with a financial salesperson and not so much an advisor. So having a detailed financial plan is important. And number six, part of that plan is your savings drawdown strategy. You want to make sure that you build plans in there to make it last. Because, you know, a good analogy for that would be if you don't plan right with your investments, your retirement could be like a 30-year mortgage. I know my grandfather actually had more years than that in retirement, but you think about that. You buy a house, you get a mortgage, you get a 30-year mortgage, and then you make that first payment and very little of the principal's paid, most of it's interest. All right. And then each time you make another payment, just a little bit more principal's paid. And then when you finally get to the end of it, at the end of 30 years, lo and behold, that $300,000 debt that you had 30 years ago is gone. And hey, that's great. You got your deed and you're in retirement. House is paid off. That's great. Now, the problem a lot of people have is when they look at drawdown strategies, and this, I'm going to do a show on the 4% rule that I think has a lot of holes in it, because even Morningstar has changed that to 2.8% in this turbulent environment. And what that means is that there used to be an old adage, if you have $1 million, you can draw 4% out of it. And that's 40 grand a year before taxes. And you got a reasonable chance, you know, something like 90% chance of not running out of money before you die. That's changed now with the way the markets and interest rates are. And even Morningstar has recently come out and says 2.8. So think about that, 2.8%. But getting back to the mortgage analogy, you had a 30-year mortgage, you paid it off. But what if you're taking your income from growth and you're slowly drawing down your principal? Well, it ends up being like a 30-year mortgage in reverse if you haven't planned it right. And then boom, you get toward the end of your retirement and there's no money left. But then again, look at where we are now in the market. What if, and we've had one in 2000 and one in 2008, 50% drawdown. That changes that whole withdrawal rate totally. So think about that. And when we get back, we're going to talk a little bit more about the 10 steps you need to take before you retire.
At Brad Williams Financial Services, our goal is to develop enduring, long-term personal relationships with our clients, knowing that you have placed your trust in our expertise and dedication. To learn more about Brad Williams Financial Services or to set up a complimentary review,
call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
If you own a 401k, an IRA, 403b, or any other retirement account, and you're between the ages of 64 and 72, this message is for you. Consider this your personal invitation to join Brad Williams for a special educational event at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. Brad's going to be talking about how to calculate your RMDs, does a Roth conversion make sense for you, tax-saving strategies, and setting up beneficiaries to help create maximum tax efficiency. This educational event will be held Thursday, June 13th, 2 p.m., and Tuesday, June 18th, 2 p.m., at the Huntsville Madison County Senior Center. To reserve your seat, call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. This is not a sales seminar, and the workshop is free and no obligation. Reserve your seat today at 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
All right, now, going back, you know, we've talked about climbing the retirement mountain. We've talked about having a financial plan. We've talked about income strategies and why, you know, you don't want to turn your retirement into a 30-year mortgage in reverse and why that's something you got to look at. Number seven is you may want to look at long-term care insurance or long-term care coverage in one of numerous ways it's available. I've done shows on long-term care. You can go back, go to the AskBradShow.com and listen to those. I don't want to spend this time going over that. But planning for healthcare expenses is very important, and I think it's something you want to do. I've also done some shows on estate planning. A lot of my clients have used a great law firm that's what they specialize in, to put together trusts and wills and powers of attorneys and why those are necessary. You know, putting together that part of your plan is really important too. Number 9, you need to check and recheck your plans. And what I mean by that is a plan is something that changes with the environment. There's an old military adage that no battle plan survives first contact. You know, you might say that about retirements too, because things change. You know, if you retired in 2009, you had an upward market for a good while. If you're retiring now, you may not be so sure what it's going to do. But having a written plan, going back to number 5, is really critical. And what I mean by written plan is not just a general outline. I'm talking about something that details everything. And if that's something you want to talk about, if you don't have a written plan, if you feel like you've been dealing with a financial salesperson and not a financial advisor, and you're looking for a retirement Sherpa, then give us a call, 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. Now, we're going to go into the last one, the 10th step that you need to take in retirement. And that is, you need to adjust your retirement financial plan to compensate for risk and longevity. And so that's where we get back into, are you investing for growth? Are you investing for income? Because the formula I write on the board in my office all the time when I'm meeting with clients, just to remind them, is TR equals G plus I. Total return equals growth plus income. And a lot of people, when they think income, they think, okay, well, I got some bond funds in there. That's good for income. Well, bond funds probably not going to be the best place going forward, because we've come out of a period of low interest rates, of declining interest rates, and now we're heading back into a period of increasing interest rates. And during those periods, the value of that bond, when you buy an individual bond and you hold it to maturity, then the only risk is that you're not getting as much return as other people are getting. But when you get to the end of it, you get your money back. When you buy a bond in a bond fund, and unfortunately, a lot of financial salespeople, when they, you know, they get that stock bond portfolio mix, they use bond funds. When we're in a period of rising interest rates, bond funds can lose value because the value of the bond goes down as interest rates go up. So if somebody has a 3% bond and the new bonds are 5 and they want to sell that bond early, then they're going to take a loss on that bond because other people can get a comparable bond for a higher interest rate. Well, that value of that bond is calculated in that bond fund. So that's a discussion that if you're heavily into bond funds, we may want to have. If you're not sure about how to position yourself for income and how you should be defensive in your portfolio going in retirement, call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048. We can set up a 1-hour consultation. We can even set up a 15-minute phone consultation. Just give us a call, 844-343-6048. We look forward to talking to you soon.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails.
That's all the time we have for today. To learn more about Brad Williams Financial Services or to set up a complimentary review,
call 844-343-6048. That's 844-343-6048.
Investment advisory services offered through Sound Income Strategies, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisory firm. Brad Williams Financial Services and Sound Income Strategies, LLC are not associated entities.